Hi everybody, it's repair time again, and this time a camcorder. Bought off of eBay for about £20, marked as faulty, won't power up. I thought, well, for £20 can't really go wrong, it's worth taking a punt even just to have a look inside one of these things. So it's a Panasonic SDR-H81. It's not an HD camera, it's an SD camera, but I figured if I could get it up and running, it would do for the wife to take video of the dog. So let's open up the box and see what we've got. Okay, it did say it came with some accessories, but not all, so it'll be interesting to see what we've got. CDs, manual, usual stuff. And here's the camera itself. Looks pretty clean. Doesn't look like it's been too well abused externally anyway. Right down there. Got AC power cord, USB cable, and actually that's about it. So back to the camera. So what we don't have is a battery. But it does run off a DC, a 9.3 DC source, so I'll hook up to an external power supply and we'll see where we go from there. We'll power it up. Okay, I've hooked up to a 9.2 volt DC adapter, which covers the supply needed. It didn't come with an SD card, so I've put one in. It does say it's got an internal 60 gigabyte hard drive. But whether it's fitted or not inside, I don't really know. I don't know much about this particular model of the camera. So let's open up the lens here and let's power it up and see what happens. Power supply is on, and here we go. Okay, I'm getting some lights on the front, which is indicating power up. The hard disk access light came on, and I do have a power light, but I don't appear to have anything on the LCD. So let's go down onto one of the play modes. Again, the access to the hard drive light came on. I've still got power on the camcorder. Now let's go back to the record mode. It did say in the ad that it wasn't powering up. Well, clearly I am getting power up, although I'm not getting, don't appear to be getting full power up. I've got nothing on the LCD, although I'm sure I've seen a quick flash. You may not have caught it on the video there, but I'm sure I've seen a quick flash when it did power up. So let's go and have a look at the lens itself. I'm in the recording mode at the moment, so let's see if I am getting some activity on the zoom. No, I can't see the lens moving at all, so it would appear like the camera's sort of frozen up. Let's switch it off again and try again. Yeah, that's it powering down. It is powering up, it is beeping to power up and power down, so clearly the processor would appear to be doing something inside the camera. So let's try again. Let's switch it straight on to record mode. I'm sure I saw a flash there, and I am getting a beep, so clearly something's going on. And yes, I'm not getting any activity. I can't see the lens moving in and out whilst I zoom. It does have a mechanical lens, a mechanical zoom, this camera, so I should be seeing something. So, let's twist the display around, see what happens. Ah, I have activity. Let's try that again. So clearly when the lens is on, the LCD is orientated this way, I do appear to be getting full power up. And yes, and when I operate the zoom, I can clearly see the lens going back and forward inside the camera. Now let's twist it back around again, and it goes dark. it would appear that there's an orientation problem with the LCD itself. There is usually some sort of contact or some sort of way of detecting the orientation of the LCD in order to flip the picture upside down for when you've got it obviously orientated that way. You want an upside down display compared to that way, it reverses it on the LCD. So obviously there's something wrong when it's in this mode here. There could just be a contact problem somehow or other, and it's when it's in this position, possibly the LCD is not telling the processor board inside how to orientate the display, so it's just sort of freezing up. That's a guess at the moment, but the first thing I want to do is orientate it so I can get power on and actually see if it will record something. So let's press the record button and see what happens. Okay, I'm just pointing at myself at the moment. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. And I'll stop the record. And it says it's pausing. Okay, so that should be recorded. So I'll go into play mode. I believe that's the play mode there. Now reading data. And yes, I can see an icon showing the one video that's been recorded onto the, well, it's either the SD card or the hard disk inside it, I'm not too sure. And I can play.
I'm just pointing at myself at the moment.
Yes, so it is recording.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Alright, so I'll pull it down, so that's me stopping it now. So now that I'm in play mode, I'll try reversing the display again. So it's working when you pull it out, twist it round, and the display goes blank. So yes, I think I'll have to open it up and see if I can find out, see if there's some sort of contact problem or wiring problem, connector problem in there. Okay, off camera I've managed to remove the one of the side covers which gave me access to the hard drive which just popped out. And what I'm trying to do is get in behind here is where the LCD is on its flip mount. So looks like I have to take off this front lens cover assembly here, and to do so I have to disconnect one or two sensors at the front there. A small light sensor there, it's just on a cable there, but it's underneath the hard disk tray. So I've removed the screws from the hard disk tray, and that's it out, and there I have access to the internals of the camera itself, which all looks pretty nice and neat actually. A lot of flat flex cables and a couple of PCBs at the bottom, and the power PCB at the back there. And like I said, so I've disconnected this cable here, so hopefully the front panel, this front lens assembly, the cover anyway, should come off. There, I just don't see any more screws, but it's, that's not sure what's going on here. So I'll just flat flex here going down onto the microphones, two microphones at the front of the camera. If I can just lift up that connector there, I believe. That's it. Now, I'm not sure what's holding it at the front at the top there. That's it, there we go. So let's cover it off. Now we've pretty much got access to the internals of the camera. And more importantly for me, I've got access to the LCD there. So I'll just have to try and work out now how it actually the orientation sensor works, if indeed that is a problem. Okay, I've taken off the small cover that covers the hinge for the LCD, and I can actually see there's actually a small micro switch there, right in there at the end of the screwdriver here, and I hope you can see this in the camera, but if I rotate the lens back and forward, you can see it operating the micro switch there. That's not small, the plastic end of the micro switch as it moves back and forward. At the moment it's pretty hard to see right enough, but obviously the micro switch is doing something. I'm not seeing any other damage on the flat flex, the data cable for the actual LCD. And presumably the actual micro switch is working, because it's obviously managed to send a signal back into the processor board to tell it to turn the picture upside down. So I'm not too sure at the moment what the fault may be. Okay, I did a little bit more testing there, and what I did was I manually operated the micro switch with the camera powered up, and it did indeed toggle the LCD either working or blank. So I think by that I can deduce that it's not a flat flex cable problem, like a cracked cable that's maybe making and breaking when you turn it, when you turn the flip the LCD out, etc. It's something, you know, something else, because operating the micro switch actually causes a problem. So I think that there's a small two-conductor flat flex there, which I presume comes from the micro switch and goes onto the electronics on the board. So I'm presuming that's all okay as the signal's reaching the processor board. So, you know, it's a weird problem that the camera should actually lock up when it's been told to flip, you know, and you get a blank screen. It's almost like it's a firmware issue. You know, I'm presuming that the actual flipping's done in software. It's not done in hardware. It's not like it's switching from two outputs on the processor board here, depending on which mode you're running the LCD, either upside down or normal. I can't see that being the case. I just think there's a single output to the drive output to the LCD, and it's software that's doing the flipping. You know, in that case, you know, I can't see, you know, any hardware issue. Thinking about this a little bit further, I'm just wondering whether the camera's going into a power save mode somehow when the LCD's orientated in the normal position, and that power save mode has been activated somehow, you know, via the micro switch, obviously. Not too sure. I know that some cameras have got power save buttons and switches on them that, you know, do disable the LCD, but I'm not sure if they would actually disable the the functionality of the camera, which is what I'm getting here. You know, like I said, when it goes in, when the display goes blank, you know, everything's basically locked up. You can't zoom in and out the lens at all, so it's just, maybe it's going to some power save mode via the LCD. Half thinking about if I can reset the firmware. Maybe there's a function in the menu on the LCD that I can do that. That might be a quick fix. So I've got to power the backup again, and what I do notice is that, you know, I've got the hard disk connected again, just so that I can get power. And when I do rotate the LCD till it powers down, I can hear the hard disk clicking as I rotate the LCD. I don't know if you can hear that. It does look like it's going into some power save mode. But another thing I notice, I've put it in play mode, and maybe go into one of the menus here. Let's go down to the LCD brightness. So there's the LCD brightness. You basically can go up or down with the button to vary it. So if I put it on the very bottom one and rotate the LCD till it goes off, and then whilst it's still in that off mode, operate the button twice, bring it back, you can see that I have gone up twice there, so the button and the camera was activating, it was working even with the display blank, so it wasn't going into a power save mode on the play function of the camera, which is a little bit odd. Yeah. So I'm just going to scroll through the menus here and see if there's a reset, possibly a hidden menu for resetting the whole camera. So I might need to. That's good. I think I'll have to read the manual here. Just notice something there. You've got the. So the power lamp there, so the LCD's on at the moment there, the power LED there. When you flip it and the LCD goes off, basically got a flashing green light there, which to me seems a little bit like it's going into power save mode of some kind. Okay, a quick read of the manual there, and yes, you can basically turn the camcorder off and on by closing the LCD. In this case, it's not powering down completely, it's just going into power save mode. I presume it would power completely down if I was using a battery rather than a DC input. I think possibly the green light flashing off and on there is just basically telling me that I've still got DC input power. Okay, I turned off the quick start feature in the menus, in the setup menu in the camera. So now when I orientate the LCD so that it goes blank, the camera is completely shutting down. So it thinks it's flipped closed. As opposed to, you know, just being able to reverse the LCD. So it looks like I could be back to the micro switch again. There's obviously two modes here for the orientation of the LCD. Obviously up and down the way, but also when it's closed. So that's the second mode. So somehow or other, I'll have to check out the micro switch there. Possibly there's another micro switch which detects when it's actually closed. And with the LCD facing inwards, and that will then tell the camera to shut down. Presumably, when the LCD's open and flipped in any direction, including flipping it back with the LCD facing out the way, the camera will remain on. But somehow or other, that's not working as it should. So I think I need to go back and dig a little deeper here and see if I can find a second micro switch. So yes, there is a second micro switch. We've got the first micro switch up in here, which detects the orientation of the LCD. But there's a second micro switch. Where was it? Right here. Right in here. And there's a little lever on the plastic hinge of the LCD, which operates that micro switch. So I think I'll investigate that a little bit further and see if that switch is actually working. Okay, I think I might have got it fixed. I turned off the quick start feature on the camera which is meant so that when you flip the LCD back home again, it powers down the camera completely. So I'd then enabled the quick start feature again, which it was when I first started all of this, and I played around with the manually operated the micro switch that operates when you flip the the LCD closed. And now when I flip the LCD back to the normal operation, which made it go blank before, it's now working. I'm gonna flip it back again, and you can see there's a, I don't know if you can see that in the camera, but in this mode here you get basically a lot of data on the LCD. And usually with these cameras, when you flip them to the facing the front position, basically all that data goes away and you've just got the picture. And that appears to be working. And it's flipping upside down, as it should do when it's facing the front. And it's obviously normal when it's facing the back. So now, if I shut the LCD, you can see the LCD goes off and I can hear the hard disk powering down. And if I open it again, it's working, and I can flip it to the front and it's working. So to tell you the truth, I don't really know what I've done. All I did was manually operate the micro switch that operates when you close the LCD a couple of times, and I disabled, then enabled the quick start feature again. So I don't think it was a micro switch, because I can see the the small lever was activating. It does activate when you operate, you push the LCD back, and I was just doing exactly the same. I wasn't doing any more or any less throw on the actuator by doing it manually. So I'm thinking at this time that it's when I enabled and disabled, etc., the quick start feature. I think that's somehow or other reset the firmware inside the camera. I think maybe it was some corrupt flash memory in the camera itself. Okay, here we have the camcorder back together again. It's powered off at the moment, so nothing on the LCD. So I'm going to try and see if she's working in the record mode on the back, and flip out the LCD. And yes, we've got a functioning LCD. And if I rotate it to the front, yes, it inverts and data disappears. And flip it back in, and it's fine. And play mode. That's playback mode's displaying fine there. Flip it forward and it inverts. So it appears to be working now. Job done.